I'm not gonna lie, that song right there just got me fucking hyped as shit. Welcome everybody to Let's Play Tales of Berseria. Yes indeed, Funky G is finally dipping his toe into the Tales of RPG series, and damn it, we're going back to the intro. Skipping it, obviously. I'm not gonna make you watch it again, even though it's awesome. Yeah, I have actually not played any Tales games on the channel, for those of you who are watching this and did not know this. I have, however, played a few Tales games. I'll talk more about that as we kind of go. Right now, I'm not going to go into my whole history of Tales games. But, yeah. So, Tales of Berseria. Why are we playing this one of all the games that are possible that I haven't played? Because there is a lot of them. Main reason we're playing this is because, first of all, I own the game. The reason why I own the game is because our girl Maro actually gifted it to me for my birthday last year, so big thanks to her for hooking me up with a physical PS4 copy. Appreciate it. And, well, I've also heard that this game is one of the best in the series, if not the best up to this point. My personal favorite is actually Tales of... Man, I have a hard time deciding, actually. But my personal favorite is probably still Tales of Symphonia. Even though I do love Vesperia almost just as much. And like I said, I'll talk more about that later. But I haven't played any Tales games in a very long time. Big reason being Let's Plays, and I just never rotated one into my Let's Play schedule ever. So they just kind of been sitting on the back burner for a very long time. And, well, I'm just ready, man. I'm ready. You know what I'm super ready for, especially? I know I'm going to have to read sometimes, but I know these games are mostly fully voice acted. So I'm ready to listen to some voice acting and not have to speak to make voice acting happen out of my mouth. That's going to be great. There's not a lot to choose from here. I'm just going to click new game. Looks like we have battle difficulty normal, simple. Difficulty is recommended for players with... you will receive less experience from battles, but more gold and higher bonus experience. Okay, I feel like I should at least do moderate. But there's also hard mode. This difficulty is for players who want to challenge. The power of allied healing arts is reduced, making smart tactics a must. So I know I already have one person in the chat yelling at me to do hard mode. You can wonder, you can guess who that is. but I don't know. Moderate seems reasonable. Obviously, normal would have just been my standard regular difficulty. But moderate actually seems reasonable. But let me read the rest of these things. Input buffer window. Adjust the amount of time allowed for buffering commands during a combo. Okay, so I guess when you're doing a combo, if you don't press it fast enough, I'm going to leave it on short for now, and we'll see how that goes. I think these are things I can change at any time. It's no big deal. I'm going to leave battle controls just whatever the default is for now, because might as well play a default and see how it goes. And if I don't like something, I'll think about changing it later. Menu shortcuts, it's fine. Vibration, you can stay on for now, I guess, until you bother me or not. Map rotation speed, I'll leave it normal. Everything else is probably fine being normal, to be honest. TV speaker and wireless controller speaker. I just want it to come out of the TV speaker, please. I don't want anything coming out of my dang controller. I'll leave the music volume all default until it's too loud or not loud enough. And I think everything else is probably good. So it really just comes down to, do I do moderate or do I do hard mode? Dragon over here trying to convince me to do hard mode. And again, I have played Tails games before, so I'm aware of the general idea of what I'm going to have to do. But obviously with every new Tails game, they always add some new stuff that you have to learn. And I'm sure this one has all sorts of different shit than the last time I played a Tails game. I don't know. I got Maro yelling at me, don't do hard mode. I got Dragon obviously yelling at me to do hard mode. Frog is telling me to go for broke, which I assume means go for hard mode. Does anybody else want to try and be a voice of reason? Terra tells me not to listen to Dragon. That's not a surprise. Anybody else? All right. For the sake of this game not taking me longer than it needs to, I'll play it on moderate. I won't play the normal mode because that seems like it's probably too easy, to be fair. Because the fact that there even is a moderate mode makes me think, okay, we should play that, because I'm not a fucking idiot. I will have to learn how to play the game, but once I get good at it, I'll be sad that it's too easy, probably. So, and yeah, okay, and Dragon just pointed out, we can change it later. It does say that. So, I suppose if I hate it, we can always go back and make it harder. So, you know what? We'll just leave it at moderate for now. Let's play moderate. I'm okay with starting with moderate. Let's do this.
You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please.
You'll be just fine with these. Celica enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Celica is safe. It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Laffy's older sister, and your student.
I don't look good. Mm-mm. Oh, snap. Okay, we got werewolves. Everybody run. It was all a dream. A terrible nightmare. What the f... Okay. Okay. Was not expecting a demon hand, but okay. Freaking Dante. Dante's sister over here. Or not Dante. Nero, right? No. Shit. What's the kid who walks around with the demon hand? Fuck. Devil May Cry kid. You know what I'm talking about.
The world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
Okay.
Luffy, time to wake up. Okay. Morning. I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore. Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good. Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today. Until then, you stay in bed, got it? What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape. Sorry, you'll have to wait. Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to. Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money'll have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself, then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my student's abilities. Sorry to put you in a spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet. Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening. Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
Okay. Wow, right off the bat with a button layout mapping thing. Okay, cool. Let's read it real quick, shall we? But I will say one thing. When she spouted off that little, like, rule number one, all I kept thinking was... Dwarven rule number one, love and friendship will always prevail, or whatever the hell the line is. That's from Tales of Symphonia, by the way. All right, so it looks like pretty basic stuff. Menu is the center button thing. Triangle will have skits. So in previous Tales games, they definitely have these little like skit things where characters would talk to each other. Curious if it'll be voice acted in this one. They were not voice acted in the last two that I played. At least I don't... No, I'm pretty sure they weren't voice acted in Vesperia. Map is square. Okay. You were thinking I was going to mention the thing from Xenoblade Chronicles 2? Like the vows in that game also. Yeah, I didn't even think of that. Honestly, I was trying to compare things to Tales because this is Tales. So anyway, this is the first Tales game I've played in a long time. The ones I played originally were Tales of Symphonia, and then I played Tales of Vesperia, and I've played a couple of other spin-off type stuff, like Tales of Symphonia 2, Dawn of the New World. Never have I played one where the camera is completely free like this. Even in Vesperia, the camera was not free. Everything was fixed camera angles. So this is interesting. All right, so we're going to look around a little bit. I doubt we're going to be able to interact with much. But hey, who knows? Other than the child, my sister.
Rest up, all right? Don't forget to take some gels with you. You know, you're careless sometimes. I'll be fine. You just make sure. Don't worry about me. I'll be in bed resting. You better be.
So gels are basically like your potions in this world, you know? Basic potion. We got a gel. Ooh, there's a shiny on the wall. Let's get that. Tarnished silver coin. Minted centuries ago, the silver should fetch a different price. Okay, so sellable item, I guess. Based on that description. Okay. Let's go up here. So yeah, I'm already intrigued. I mean, I'm liking this girl's style, this velvet chick. She already is she's pretty shall we say pleasant to look at. That's probably the best way to put it. Ooh, found some garlic. Whoop. Used in fried albatross. Okay, that's probably an ingredient, because in Tales games usually you can cook between battles to heal up in between battles. That's usually a thing. Is this a door I can go in? No. Any other shinies that I'm not seeing? I don't think so. All right, heading outside, y'all. Let's do it. Minimap. Minimap showing your current surroundings displayed on the upper left screen. You can use it to check location, next objective, shops, and more. All right. Area map. Press square square is the area map button. Unlike minimap, the area map shows which region you're in, the whole region. Current objective. R1 to display the current main story objective in the upper right. Additionally, the event list on the area map displays objectives in progress. Got it.
If I'm on the hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Laffy's medicine, so I can't mess this up.
Laffy must be sick or whatever. Okay, well, I'm digging the map. I'm digging the beautifulness of the world. First of all, this game is freaking beautiful so far. Have I mentioned that in general? Look at this freaking... the trees all yellow and red and different shades of it and stuff. It's pretty cool. Yellow, red, orange kind of mixtures going on. Found a zucchini. Woot. Velvet, don't get any ideas with that zucchini now. I'm sorry, I went there already. We just got started here, man. Already making it lewd. I'm sorry. But I'm also not sorry. You knew what you signed up for when you watched Funky G play a video game. God damn it. Especially with my chat. It'll only get more debaucherous from here. And yes, I am streaming this live, by the way, if anybody didn't catch that already. For those of you watching this on YouTube. It's fine. She's legal. I hope so. If she wasn't legal, I'll have to go back and edit that out. Anyway, what's up, kid? Can we talk to everybody? Okay. Apparently you can't just talk. Wait.
Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. Maybe he's just worn out? That does it. I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. That ought to pick him right up. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers and weariness alike.
All right. I am so hyped that this game has full voice acting. Oh my god, I love it. Love it. Well, maybe not with every villager, but at least it has it in general. But I'm not going to bother sitting here reading every word these guys saying this is important. But yeah, blah, blah, blah. Saul said talking to someone, but he was all alone. Isn't that right, Othello? Meow. Was Laffy talking to Ceres? What was he doing at the store alone? Talking to himself, was he? Now that you mentioned Arthur used to have the same habit, didn't he? So wait. It's completely true. When I was heading back from the shop, I saw Laffy said talking to someone. Okay, so I think the face on over their head changed. I'm thinking that means they don't have any new dialogue. That's actually really, really convenient to know whether or not you should talk to an NPC anymore. If they have a new dialogue to talk about, they'll be like, hey, I got something new to say. Let me talk to you then. Brr, just isn't warming up, is it? Leaves change earlier every year. I wonder what could be causing it all. I don't know. Can't go in that house. All right, keep it moving, y'all. Keep it moving. So I see you talking about a bunch of different voice actors and stuff right now, Tara. So from what I cap there, are you saying that Arthur's voice was Noctis? Is that what you were saying earlier? And I'm assuming you're talking about Velvet's voice is somebody also. Anyway, what's up with the exclamation points?
Ever since the opening 7 years ago, this world's really gone crazy. Famine, freezing weather, and worst of all, this demon blight that's turning people into monsters.
I can't believe that people can really turn into those things. It's a nightmare.
Does no one know what causes demon blight? Or how to heal it?
No. What we do know is that when people turn into those monsters, I mean, demons, they gain incredible strength and attack humans on sight.
Whoever named it the opening named it right. It's like someone opened a portal directly to hell.
Come to think of it, Celica died during the opening, didn't she? It might be a good thing she died when she did. She didn't have to suffer through all of this.
It's good that my sister died? How can you say that?
Sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
You're a real idiot, you know that?
Sorry about him, Velvet.
Yeah, what a dick. You got more to say, dude? Thanks to the fence to keep out the demons, the village is barely half the size it was 10 years ago. Still, I guess the population is also a third of what it was, so it's not crowded at least. So that's cool. Which is worse, you think? Becoming demon grub or slowly starving to death? Don't talk like that. But when I go, I want it to be quick and painless. Okay. So this demon blight thing, I guess that had to do with what happened and wiped out a big portion of the town and all that. We got to learn more about that, I'm assuming. Probably going to be a big plot point in terms of, you know, the evil going around in this world. There's always evil, and in this game, it's probably the demon blight. So the Velvet is voiced by the voice actor of Shantae. So Shantae, like Shantae in the Shantae platforming games, those ones? I didn't even know she had a voice actor or actress, I guess. But yeah, okay, that's cool. And after every story event, all NPCs in the entire world can have new dialogue. Well, I mean, if they're going to have a marker over their head that they have something new to say or not, I would imagine that makes sense, Dragon. So obviously, I won't guarantee I'll talk to everybody, but I feel like in some cases with Tales games, you end up having to go back to talk to people for certain things, especially if there's side quests involved. So I'm not going to say I will, and I'm not going to say I won't go around and talk to everybody over and over again, but we'll see how I feel as I play this game. And I know I'm kind of moving slow right now, but I just want to... I'm getting a feel for it right now. Got to get all my initial thoughts out.
Is Lafayette feeling better?
No, not yet. He needs a little more rest, I think.
Aw, too bad. Tell him I'm looking forward to hunting beetles with him again when he's better.
Right, got it. Lafayette's illness sure is persistent.
Wait, Lafayette's a girl? I mean, not... keeps coming back. Lafayette's a dude? I thought Lafayette was a girl.
The medicine always helps a little bit, but still, that sounds terrible. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help. Thanks, but we'll be fine. At least we've got Arthur to take care of anything that needs muscle. And before he came, Celica raised me and Luffy all by herself. So now I have to do my best too.
You sound just like your sister. That optimism must run in the family.
I do? That's nice of you to say.
That's cool. Hope Lafayette gets well soon. Thanks, he'll be able to play once his fever's better. All right. Oh, someone said they saw a bunch of demons near the village. Be sure to lock up tight. I see. Watch out for yourself too then. Okay, bye. Bye.
I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest.
Oh, I was planning on it. I'm gonna get them gels.
But like Arthur always says, battles are won and lost with the preparations made before the first strike.
Speaking of gels, chest with 4 apple gels right now. 3 kinds of treasure chests can be found in various places. Each contains different kind of items. Copper has consumables. Silver has standard equipment. Gold has exceptional equipment. Does that mean it's random? Like the chest, maybe chest placement isn't random, but what's inside of them is random? Huh. That's just an assumption. I have no idea yet, but that's weird that they would have 3 different types of chests. Unless it's just like, just so you know you're about to get something good right now. Anyway, the leaves are starting to fall. Must be about time for start roasting some potatoes. I roasted some potatoes today, or actually I fried some up in a pan, and they were fucking good. Anyway, busy as always. Gotta feed the family and all. If you need some vegetables, feel free to take a few. You really mean it? I might just take you up on an offer. Free veggies! Free veggies! Hell yeah. Got some nutmeg. That's not a veggie. Do I care about the answer, Dragon? Not yet. That answer is rhetorical until the game tells me or not. You already know. I don't want to know the answer to anything unless I actually ask directed at the chat. Anyway, copper coin missing a fragment, barely worth the metal it contains. So that is... No, it didn't. It just told me that the chests are different. That didn't tell me whether or not the chests are randomly, like, respawning or anything like that. Randomly spawned. It didn't say that. If you ask me, wild prickly boar meat beats rapig any day of the week, but still. There's fried cutlets, bacon ribs, roast rapig, and the ears. Those are simply delectable. I mean, there's bacon. That's all I need to know. Bacon. Bacon. All right, Let's talk to my... Oh, there's a silver chest. Resistance ring. Okay. It was a silver chest, so I knew it was going to be equipment. Anyway, hey, Velvet. Doing any shopping? Just stocking up a little bit, heading down to the Hunters. Get us with supplies, after all. How's the baby doing? We're all quite healthy, thank you. Do you want to try changing the one's diaper? It would be long before doing real, you know. I don't think I'm ready for that just yet. I'm only 16. She's not of age yet, guys. She's only 16, so pretend I said nothing earlier. But changing diapers I can do. Time passes quicker than you think, and you're a pretty girl. I'm sure the boys in the village will pick up on that, and the boys from out of town, too. I'd better go while they're still light. Talk to you later. I didn't mean to scare you. All right, dear. Take care now. You hear? I mean, Velvet's already a beast of a woman. She's taller than this bitch right here. Fucking 16-year-old giant. Alright, anyway, let's talk to the shop guy. Hey, Velvet, if you need any hunting supplies, come to me now if there's anywhere else to go. Alright, sir. You got gels. That's all he's got. You got none but gels. And they're fucking expensive, and I only have 200. You know what? I'm not buying any of your stinking gels. I don't even have enough money to buy more than two right now. So unless I find some money, I'll hold off. I already found a box full of four gels. Hopefully that'll get me through the beginning part here. For now. Mind you, I am not playing it on the easiest mode, but we'll see what happens. I'm assuming this is a save point? Yeah, okay. Additionally, you can create a quick save by pressing... Yeah, sorry, by pressing options menu in the pause menu, and that, whatever, okay. I was reading that wrong. Oh, I do have a coin to sell. You are right. I did forget about that. According to the calendar, tomorrow should be Scarlet Night. The opening 7 years ago was on Scarlet Night, too. I hope nothing terrible happens. It'll be the same when Celica died. Ah, shit. We're going to get repeat events from DePaste. Speak. They say that the outlaws holed up in the Morgana Woods all came down with demon blight. We have to consider defending the village. Yeah, but you were saying that the fence like this wouldn't stand up against an assault by demons. And maintaining is hard enough when there's so few of us, we need to build something stronger. True dat. I'm not 100% sure I need to go this way or the other way. I'm going to finish exploring first, though. Also, I did just notice on the map, it does show the treasure chests. So maybe they do reset? I don't know. Speaking of things I got, let's check out the menu real quick, because I did pick up a ring to equip. We already have the blood blade and the sturdy belt and the battle garment. But I picked up a resistance ring. My art defense plus 5. Hell yeah, let's do it. Focus plus 5. Okay. Battle boots. HP recovery on defeating of foes. That's actually always a really cool skill to have in any of these games. Killing foes, get your HP back. We got arts. What kind of... Ooh, she got... Oh. Wait. Hold on. What? Okay, now I'm confused. Why are there different stages? Huh. That's new. Let's not worry about it right now. Let's worry about it when we actually get into our first battle. I'm sure it'll be like a tutorial battle anyways. Hey there, Velvet. Have you heard the news? There are some folks going around pretending to be exorcists and tricking villagers out of their money. They say they can see things that are invisible to ordinary eyes. You've heard that one before, right? Are you talking about Arthur? Just a rumor I'd heard. These are trying times we live in, however you slice it. I'm just saying we can't be too careful. Arthur going around scamming people? Never. Comfrey? Oh, it's a kind of grass. Okay. Yeah, battle boots, not battle bootay.
The demon blight is a punishment. Sent to us by the Empyreans for forgetting the old prayers.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
All right, then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course, of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16.
Yeah, get it right, old lady. Shrine of the Cape has no name. It's silent shrine of tranquility. Something nameless sleeps there. Daemons and Empyreans slumber within. Into the deepest depths, in perfect silence, sleep. Fade. Take care on your way home, alright? Alright. Hold up. One question. So we don't know which way it goes to where yet. They're just question marks. I was just curious. Why is there an exclamation point here? Is there more dialogue that I missed back at home now? Interesting. I don't know. I'm getting that the green dots are NPCs to talk to. The exclamation points are NPCs who actually have voice acted like an actual scene to talk to. Anyway, let's just talk to this person real quick. Hi, Velvet. Off to hunt prickle boars again. Take care, then. The cold has them hungry, and that makes them even meaner than ever. I'll be fine. You know me. Hunting's what I do best. Yeah, I know you can do the same thing, too. Still, I hear the beasts are falling to demon blight just like humans these days, so be careful out there. Beasts becoming demons? Gotcha. I'll be extra cautious. Thanks for the warning. Thanks. All right. Any other random items along this path? Because otherwise, I'm going to head back home real quick. Because I'm a little confused as to why there's an exclamation point back at my house. And I'm wondering if there's, like, some special scene that I can now check out back at home. I'm going to do that real quick. Can I go any faster than this, or is this as fast as I can go? I think this is... I can only go slower. I'm just curious. I also got to keep an eye out for the little thing I'm popping up on the bottom that's like, press triangle to see scene. Sometimes those are situational in these games too, so you have to see, you gotta try not to miss those. Oh, there's definitely an exclamation point here.
Keep warm and no going outside.
Sheesh, you don't trust me at all. It'll get dark if you don't leave soon.
Do you need to be quite so suspicious of me? I do have feelings, you know. Sorry, I was just worried, not suspicious, all right? Okay, so now that I understand how the little icons above people's heads work, that I just missed out on part of the dialogue because I didn't keep talking to him when he had an exclamation point over his head. Now it makes sense. Now that I know that, I'll remember not to leave a spot until I've at least got all the exclamation points out of the way. All right. And now that I know that, like, shinies are a thing, I gotta keep an eye out for shinies on the ground and shit. All right. Let's get to it then, shall we? We're going hunting, y'all. We're gonna go see the prowess of Velvet on display, I hope. See how badass this girl really is. Let's get hyped about it. The girl who shows up all the guys in the village. I just don't know which way I'm supposed to go, whether it's this gate or the other one. I'm just going to try them both and see what happens. But yeah, in this game it's spelled Empyrean, but Empyrean, I mean, whatever. Tomato, tomato. Also, we should make our first save. I didn't do that in the village. Let's do that. I don't know if there's any autosaves, so I'm going to be careful about that, just in case. Something tells me it might be one of those games where if you die, it just takes you back to the last screen you loaded on. It might be that kind of game. I feel like it could totally be one of those. It's kind of awesome to be playing a Tales game that's this, like, open with the camera. Like I said, that's the first time I played one that didn't have fixed camera. I'm so used to that. Another comfrey. Anyway, a cute little bunny wabbit. Oh, look at the cute little bunny. And this big ass, whatever the hell this is, some kind of cow thing that's very furry, like a yak or something. An ox. Out for a walk, Velvet? As if. I'm off to go hunting in the woods, but I have a few errands to run. Did you hear that the demons in Morgana Woods are multiplying? This is serious. Where are we supposed to run now? Are you sure that's true? Seems to be. Word hasn't even got a few of the townsfolk. You be careful out there, aight? Thanks, I will. Can't very well leave Laffy to fend for himself, can I? Certainly not. That would be very... not very big sisterly of you to leave him to his own devices. Alright, let's talk to this fellow, right, Mia?
I saw a group of dozens of demons real close to town. If they attack, we're done for. I think we should run now while we can.
Run? To where? There are demons everywhere in Midgand.
We have nothing to worry about. My brother Arthur can protect the ball.
Arthur, huh? They say he used to be one of those exorcists who could control Malachim.
And only exorcists can defeat demons. Yeah, we've all heard the fairy tales. So have all the swindlers who pose as exorcists to con honest folk out of their gold.
Hey! Arthur isn't like that!
If he was a real exorcist, why didn't he protect Celica when the demons attacked?
That's because... Luffy and I... we...
Besides, Arthur is just an outsider who drifted into our village one day. We don't know anything about his past.
Then you must think we're outsiders too. Our parents weren't from here either.
Back to business. We need to deal with these demons.
You're right. We've got to defend our village ourselves. That's what it comes down to. Save the dreaming about exorcists and Malakim for when we're asleep.
Okay then, Dick. Even walled cities are fallen to demons. How are we supposed to relax with a mere fence? They say demons can understand human speech. If that's true, then what happened 7 years ago? Demon blight and famine are merely the Empyrean's just punishments for heedless men. Can you believe this gibberish? What gives them the right to preach? When did we do something so wrong that we deserve to die? I don't know, sir. You have sinned, and for sinning you will repent. I don't know. I'm not good at the religious babble, okay? How many times have I told you not to go around touching wild animals? You could catch demon blight for all we know. Is that what you want? Become a demon? No, but that bunny was so cute. Hell yeah. How could you not touch the bunny? The adorable bunny. The adorable demon bunny who will probably gouge your eyes out the moment you look away. There's bunnies everywhere. They don't give a fuck. They're like, what? I'm a cute little bunny. What, are you gonna touch me? I don't think so. Got another comfy grass. This is bad. Morgana Woods is teeming with demons, and now we can't trade with Taliesin. If something happens to the Tranquil Woods, the village will be as good as done for. Okay. I turn back now. What's good for you? There's a bunch of demons roaming up ahead. How many? Beats me, the guy who went to check hasn't come back, but if it's a lot, the village is in real trouble. This is no time for a date in Taliesin. Shame, as I would have asked you out myself. Bitch? Sorry, I didn't catch that last part. What did you say? Nothing. Just forget it. Dude trying to hit on Velvet right now. Alright, so that way is blocked. Red means no go. Got it. Glad I checked over here first then. Just because I can't go this way. Woot. Time to walk back up the hill. Back through the Tizzity Town and back to the other side. And now we know. I'm just going to keep checking those treasure chests till I know for sure they either respawn or not. Looks like random shiny spots do respawn, so that's a thing. Because I'm pretty sure I picked up that same grass there earlier. Alright, let's go to the next spot. Welcome to the Tranquil Woods, autumn-colored forest. It's kind of beautiful here. Not sure what the star on the map means, but maybe that's my objective. Can't go upriver, unfortunately. God, this is, like, super beautiful.
This area looks promising.
Indeed, very promising. Lingzi mushroom. Two Lingzi mushrooms. Good stuff. Alright, should we go this way first? Let's see what's over here. We might get into our first battle.
Prickle boar.
Oh, it's a prickle boar. Get him! Shit, press the wrong button. Get him! Oh yeah, first battle in the game, y'all. Battle tutorial time. Combo attacks we perform based on the character number. Wait, whoa. Based on the number of souls each character possesses. Okay, so right now I have 3 out of 5 souls, it looks like. Use any combination of circle, triangle, and X and square. So any combination of all 4 of them to perform a 3-hit combo. Alright. Okay. By stunning, defeating, or inflicting status ailments upon enemies, you can get souls, allowing for more combo. Okay. Oh shit. And, the battle had just begun, y'all. Is there any reason to switch up the button I press? Doesn't seem like it matters right now. I guess it does matter.
Not bad.
Seems like the combos are a little different based on the button I use. Anyway, for winning that, I got 2 prickle boar meats. Woot. Details? Okay, so I'm pretty sure with previous games, you're getting grade for battles, and the grade you can use usually at the end of the game. You can usually redeem it at the end of the game to have bonus perks for new game pluses. That's usually how it worked in previous games. I'm assuming it'll be the same here. I got 0.54 grade overall. This is just how it broke down, how my grade breaks down. Anyway, I didn't get any gold for that, but okay. But I got the meat I was looking for, woot. Contacting an enemy with an enemy while on the field will initiate a battle. Victory is achieved by attacking and blah, blah, blah. Phil, you're in an unwinnable battle. You can run toward the edge of the screen to escape. However, you cannot flee from battlefields that have a red border. Got it.
Yeah, that's how it's done.
Pretty straightforward stuff. Pretty sure that's how the previous games worked as well. If you wanted to escape, you just had to go to the edge of the arena, and it'll have a little, bar that fills up, and you run away. You can change every button combo. I'm not sure what you mean, Dragon. Also, there is a triangle combo.
The cold weather's
combo.
Been terrible on everyone's crops, but at least the city will buy our prickleboar meat now. Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them, but they can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred with more docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkle boars? Nah, doesn't sound appetizing. What about piggle boar? Yeah, piggle boar! That's a cute name. Maybe too cute, though. We wouldn't want to discourage people from eating them.
Piggle boar bacon! So what's up with this? Can I not... Is this something I can't interact with right now? Hence the question marks, I guess. Interesting. Let's go get another pickle boar, I guess. Yo, got another copper coin. Chipped copper coin, specifically. Get that boar, y'all. Get it. Oh, the soul gauge. Arts use up the soul gauge. When the soul gauge drops to 0, you can skill it. You can still attack, but you will be knocked back if you try to defend. Okay. Okay, so eventually when it runs out, my attack will bounce off like that. Got it. Use L1 to defend. Defending decreases damage and also greatly depletes soul gauge. Also resets the camera's position. Gonna come at me, dog? There you go. Gonna come at me, dog? Someone gonna come at me? Come on, now you attack. Oh my god, please. Please come for attack so I can block, please. Please. Thank you.
Right, here goes.
Alright, now it's time to whoop ass, huh? Alright.
Know your foes and strike where they're weak.
Okay. My soul gauge had run out. Interesting. So you have to just run around to get it to come back?
Not bad.
Okay. Cool. Got more meat. Using arts when you have no soul gauge comes with a number of detrimental effects. Combo speed is slower. Combos are more easily broken. Attacks are more easily guarded against. Blah, blah, blah. Basically, you're just weaker. Status effects are less likely to be inflicted. Healing arts restore fewer HP. Stunned enemies, however, cannot guard, leaving you free to attack regardless of your soul gauge. Okay, so if they're stunned, you can just whoop ass. Just whoop that ass. Yo, give me that apple gel, though. Wait, did I already have 4 apple gels and I picked up 1 from that chest earlier? I might have misunderstood that. Because I think I just picked up 1 right now. I'm assuming this is already sorted as well. I mean, it has different categories. It'll hopefully sort itself. And all is probably just sorted by the newest thing you picked up? I don't know. All right, well, we got some boar meat. There's another screen over here. Before I do that, oh, there's a rock in the way. kind of want to go around the other way. So the soul gauge refills by guarding or just waiting. Okay. I mean, I saw that just running around got it to refill. Guard, if guarding makes it go up as well, then I'll note that as well. I don't know if this other way was a dead end. Now that I know I can't go one way, maybe I can't. Oh, this is a fucking ledge. Well, shit. Well then, really glad I looked that way before I went over here. Cool. Always pick the right way first. Son of a bitch! Alright. Well, anyway. Let's save it, and we'll go to the next area. Most likely run into a fucking demon and get the real story going. Either that, or we're gonna find Mama Boar. Mama Boar's gonna whoop our ace. Whoop that ace. Saving, please wait. Okay. Oh, this is the shrine that lady was talking about. Okay. And we got one more boar. Let's say hi. Hola! Nice. I'm just wondering if it matters if I switch up the buttons when I'm doing a combo. That's all I really meant earlier, Dragon. Was like, does it matter if I press X, square, circle, triangle, or can I just mash square? What's the difference? It doesn't seem like it changes much. At least not right now. Maybe it will later, but not now to start. All right, anyway, we got enough of the fucking meat that we needed for the medicine, so that's good. But we're going to look around, because that's what we do. It's an RPG, after all. We explore. You can fully customize your combos? Oh, I see what you're saying. You could just straight up make it whatever you want. I guess I just meant right now, since I haven't changed anything. When I looked in the menu, the button presses were all the same. Like, the combos were all the same. So I think the idea is that all four of my button combos are the same right now. So, like, square, 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 it's all always the same. And yeah, I think I got what I just said makes sense to me now. When I saw the art menu, that actually makes more sense to me now that you just said what you said. So I think I get it. Obviously, yeah, when I get more party members, it'll matter more. That's kind of what I figure. Also, I had no idea what I just picked up. I clicked through that way too fast. Oopsies. Oh, nice. Another silver coin. Sweet. Comfrey. Any other shinies on this side before I go up into the shrine and initiate something? Man, I'm just digging the openness to look around, you know? With the full 360 camera view. Digging it. Haven't played a JRPG with this setup in a while. I'm trying to think of the last one I played with an open camera like that. It's like not Xenoblade 2. Is that the last one I played like this? Where it's just big and open and you're walking around with the full camera control? I don't even remember now. More comfrey grass. Yeah, I think Xenoblade 2 also. I mean, I guess Witcher to some extent, but I was talking more of a JRPG. Another coin. And check.
This place isn't safe. That hole's gotten bigger. I've told them 1,000 times they ought to build a fence, but they keep saying it's forbidden land. Even Celica used to scare me with it. She was always, "This is a gateway to the underworld." Well, I'm too old to keep falling for that nonsense.
Okay, then. Watch Geralt get put in Smash. You know, to be fair, if they put Geralt of Rivia in Smash, that would be pretty fucking awesome. I'm not gonna lie. I don't necessarily want him in Smash, but it doesn't mean it wouldn't be cool if he was. he definitely has an array of abilities that are, you know, could be a little different. I know he uses swords, and he can use two swords, but he could also have, like, he could have other weapons, or, like, other, he definitely has different magical abilities that could be, have him use. He could even use a bunch of his potions and shit, like, as a, like, a temporary buff or something. That would be cool. But yeah, I could see it. I don't expect it, but I could see it. Also, do I? Is it worth my time to fight, refight battles? I mean, who wouldn't hurt for a little extra fucking meat? Yeah, his signs. The signs are the magic spells I was referring to, right? Those would be pretty cool, I think. So I got a couple more prickle boar meats. I'm assuming these will be good to have for recipes of cooking eventually when cooking is a thing. Again, we're still in tutorial early game mode. I'm sure it'll tell me what cooking is and how to utilize it when it becomes relevant. But for now, let's murder some more prickle boars, shall we? No. Nice, we got the stun. Got him.
Is that all?
More prickle boar meat, please. This way. Oh, shit. I'm actually going to go ahead and murder all of them. I see no reason not to. I do like that they allow you to, even though you target one, you can still hit everybody with an AoE type damage. That's always nice. Yo, we went up a level. See? Worth it. Worth it. Tell me, Velvet, wasn't worth it. She got that sweet, hot level up. She level 2. Wait, no, what level did I start at? She's level 4 now. I have no idea. Also, hold up. Oh, snap.
Wait, the boars I hunted. Are you there? Maxim 3. Never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle.
She hasn't even used a sword. She has a sword equipped, but we haven't used it at all. I don't understand. Hidden arts focus on damage and attack range, but use more of your soul gauge than the martial arts. Searing edge is effective against beasts. Gain the advantage by exploiting your enemy's weak spot. Okay, how the hell do I use it? Select arts from the battle menu and select set searing edge to X. Then press X to use it. Okay, art. To X. Searing Edge. How do I know? Huh. Okay.
Right, here goes.
Oh shit, sorry. I didn't realize we were still going. Get booked. Ooh, get it. No! Fuck him up. Is this the bigger, more badassery of them or something? Fuck out of here. Got him.
I did it.
Oh.
Cirrus.
An exorcist art.
Pride and anxiety. Pity for the enemy. Thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
Arthur?
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine.
I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of...
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me.
Bye, Artorias. Fucking quiche. Don't make that man's a quiche. Alright, anyway, we victorious. I didn't get any of the meat from that one. Oh, yes, I did. Wait, you consumed prickle boar? What? After the hunt. Alright, hold up.
I wonder if those prickle boars were brothers. Maybe I should have let them go. But then, how would I pay for Laffy's medicine? Hunting took care of that. And it means food for us as well. I had no other choice. It was a rational decision. But the fact that I'm still worrying about it shows that my feelings are getting the better of me.
Getting the better of me. All right. Just gonna roll out. Roll out. Uh-huh.